Bonjour, c'est un plaisir de vous retrouver. Grand, grand bonheur aujourd'hui d'être avec Tao Porchon Lynch. Thank you very much for accepting to do this interview.
Ça fait plaisir.
Oh, merci beaucoup. Okay. Et Tao, vous avez 99 ans, 99 years young, you are. And you are still a yoga teacher, so vous enseignez encore. Donc, vous êtes la plus vieille professeure de yoga au monde, selon le livre des records Guinness.
C'est ce qu'on dit.
Oui, c'est ce qu'on dit. Comment faites-vous pour avoir autant d'énergie à cet âge, alors que certains disent que c'est très vieux, mais pour vous, vous êtes jeune encore.
Parce qu'il y a tellement de choses à faire dans la vie et je ne veux pas rater une seule chose.
Excellent. Puis vous avez eu une vie très, très, très remplie. Et une chose, moi, que j'aime beaucoup, c'est que vous avez pas commencé à enseigner le yoga lorsque vous aviez 20 ans. Vous avez commencé à enseigner le yoga beaucoup plus tard.
20 ans? Non, pas exactement. J'ai fait du yoga quand j'avais 8 ans en Inde.
Oui.
Comme j'étais gosse.
Oui.
N'est-ce pas? Alors, c'était quand j'ai vu Indra Devi, qui venait de l'Amérique du Sud.
Indra Devi.
Et elle est arrivée chez MGM. Il m'a demandé, Tao, what are you doing? Why you do films? Why you not teach yoga? Alors, Debbie Reynolds and Catherine Grayson, she teaches yoga. And I said, no, will you teach us? So I taught Debbie Reynolds and Catherine Grayson. And then I decided that at this, I really didn't know enough. And I bet I wanted to protect my élèves. So I went to see Iyengar. And he said, I don't take women. I said,
oh, no.
So he said, then you're a snob. So he took me that very day.
Excellent. And you said, there is nothing impossible, and you that at that time.
Nothing. Absolutely. When I want to do something, I go and do it. Don't put it off till tomorrow. Tomorrow never comes. 1 minute after midnight is already today, so you can't tell it to do tomorrow.
Exactly. And something amazing that I find is when you were 85 years old,
yes,
you thought that, oh, life is exciting, but I'm missing something.
Yes.
So why not do ballroom dancing? That's an amazing story.
No, quite like that.
Okay.
I was in the act of doing a teacher's training program for yoga.
Yeah.
And at the Fred Astaire studio, they were in the act of teaching ballroom dancing. But it started to snow, so no one turned up. So they said to me, do you dance? And I said, oh, well, a little, not very much. I learned during the war, the American infantry was teaching me to jitterbug. So they said, well, I said, but before I die, I'm going to go to South America to dance the tango. I said, well, why don't you start tonight? That was at 85, so that was, I started then.
Wow.
And since then, I've won 785 first places.
No,
yes.
785.
Yes, and all of the different, how do you call it, tours where they have a Fred Astaire championship.
Yes. Wow, that's amazing. So if someone tells you, well, I'm 55 years old and I'm kind of old to do a yoga teacher training or to do this or to do that.
There's no such thing as age. Just look at the trees. They're hundreds of years old, but they're not getting older. They're tuning in to their inner self. And every year after the worst winter, they'll start up again. We can do the same. Within us is the power to redo, to recycle ourselves. And don't spend your time. If you sit there like this, you won't get anywhere. You're locking all of everything. But if I'm up here, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, exactly.
And yes.
Straight up.
Yes. Don't spend your time on things that are not necessary. When you wake up in the morning, I see this is going to be the best day of my life.
So that's part of your rituals.
Yes.
Do you have other rituals like that?
Absolutely.
What kind of rituals do you have to keep that very high energy?
I go and look at the birds and the sky, and I look at nature, and I feel nature starting to glow in the atmosphere. And so I just stay there a few moments and feel it moving inside of me. I don't let it stay down here.
Yeah.
Because my back will get tired. I let it come up with, like a tree.
And it's part of your teaching as well.
Yes.
Coming from the
roots. The seven, the tree comes up. It's wonderful. You know, the American Indians used to put their arm around the trunk of a tree and feel the sap move up. And one day I was demonstrating that, and suddenly I was that much off the ground. And they said, how did you do that? I said, do what? They said, well, you're not on the floor anymore. I said, I'm with the tree. The tree and I are breathing together.
Wow. So prana and keeping the prana very high is one of your secrets.
Yes.
And getting it everywhere you can.
Don't look for negative. And when you get up in the morning, don't even let your mind dwell on things that are negative. Know that this is a new day full of possibilities. And whatever you really want to do, if you think negative, you'll act negative and you won't get anywhere. But if you think positive, the door opens up to everything in life.
Excellent.
And you attract it towards you.
So think positive. Don't procrastinate.
Never procrastinate.
Do it.
That's
just
right.
Do it.
Don't spend your time on things that are not good for you. Spend your time on the beauty of life.
So it's easy.
Yes.
And if you want to do something, do it. That's it.
That's right. I spend my time. I love nature, and I like to protect nature, and I love animals. And soon, no matter what, I'd rather give to animals than to eat myself. I don't spend much time.
And if you would have one thing to say to someone,
yes,
what would it be?
Just don't. When you wake up in the morning, know that the sun comes up and it opens up the whole hemisphere. And it doesn't say, no, I'm only going to do this little bit there. It spreads out. So do the same thing inside of you. When you get up in the morning, know it's a new day, brand new day. Nothing to worry about. Only good things are going to happen. And then I feel joyous and I want to jump around like a child. I haven't grown up yet.
I like it.
No.
So you stay young. And you have your book, Dancing Life, that is really nice. Do you want to talk about it just a little bit?
Actually, you know, so much was written that was so ridiculous about me. And a lot of weird things and stupid things, you know, how somebody left me and this. So when I was asked about getting the book, I said, only on one condition, that every single thing in it, I can prove. So even here, when I was modeling, and they paid me, there is the check that they gave me.
Yeah?
Whatever it was that I'm talking about is in there. No silly things, only nothing made up. I just did whatever that was correct. I let be in there. March with Gandhi, my be with General de Gaulle during the war.
Oh yeah, wow.
Helping the people escape. I did this during the war.
Wow.
And
so we can read all of that.
It's all in there.
And when you were a model in Paris.
Modeling there, right, with the Dalai Lama. And he and I were laughing together. We spent time together. Look for the joy of life. Don't look for the things. So they took my advice, and every single thing we went through, And I said, that's not right. This is it.
Excellent.
So if it was written wrongly, it's so actually in
Dancing there. Light.
That's it. This one, I climbed up in Central Park in high heels. And Robert wanted to take photos of me, and he couldn't believe that I climbed up on the rock. And so I sat there and did this. And he sent that out into the world and became famous. So Australia, everybody had a photograph like that.
And now in Quebec, France, Switzerland, all the French countries as well.
Everywhere, yes.
Right. Thank you very much, Tao, for your energy.
That's what life is all about, isn't it?
Exactly.
Keep the smile going. Don't let anything trip you up or move in on you. Always something good can happen.
Thank you.
I feel it. Oh, bless you. Merci.
Merci.